was that picture I
but
had
through
in
our
my mind.
Through our conversations, can you see more than you could before?
Yeah, I can now.
Yeah, right?
But I see when you talk.
Yeah.
Because when you talk...
Because you can imagine.
When you talk, to me, it's like rain. It comes down, and it goes over what you talk about, and then it gives shape to what you talk about.
Wow.
So instead of the rain being just hitting the ground, it has a dimension, a new dimension. It's going around what you talk about.
Yeah.
And even I can see it now because it has that dimension. So I imagine, and I listen to your voice, and the raindrops, they come, pitter patter, pitter patter, but they pitter patter in a calculus around what you're talking about. And it started the first day, and then it became a new language. And now it's expanded to this point where I call it the language of rain hitting an object.
Yeah.
Because as it hits that object, you don't need sight to see it. You need to listen to the rain.
Yeah.
So it vocalizes and it conceptualizes and it starts to have shape. And then the shape starts to be fluid. And as the shape gets fluid, it has a life. And as the life moves on, it gets like a light. And then other things that are around it start trying to grab at it.
Yeah.
And as they grab at it, some get pushed away because they don't have what it takes to be part of it. And it keeps going and going. And for me, it started with your first talk, and now it's spinning, and it's spinning, and it's spinning. And when the rain hits it, it's my favorite thing, because my new favorite thing is rain.
Yeah.
Rain is Andres talking about his way of life, his craziness, his desire not to be like anything else.
That's really cool, man. I wish you could see the smile on my face, Milton. I hope my rain reaches you. I hope you can imagine the smile on my face right now, hearing you talk, man.
Wow.
You bring me so much happiness, Milton.
You know, do you know you do to me?
Yeah.
Because there's nothing like going from total darkness and silence to having someone build a light in your life and a way of communicating when rain touches things. It's like if I was deaf, not just blind, if I was deaf,
yeah,
I would still be able to communicate with you, because the rain that you create, it creates a shape that anybody can touch and feel.
Yeah.
They just have to have the mind connected to the heart, connected to the openness of how you talk.
Yeah.
Because your speech is fearless. Your speech doesn't worry about rejection. Your speech has hope, and it has angst. The angst in your speech is the humanness of potential when you try to love something to the uttermost. And when it doesn't happen, as I see your rain modulate over the surface, I see your rain take a shape in a wave. And the wave comes, and then the wave gives, and then the waves goes forward again, and then it goes back out into the middle of the ocean again, and then it comes back and hits the shore. And it's just wonderful. You're like the wave, learning, going back out to the sea, coming back again. It's really cool, because it's lighter and lighter, and each time it comes with heavier foam.
Yeah.
Like this boom right now is big and it's cresting. But it's not damaging, not at all. It's just really nice. When I felt you leave me the other day, I felt this heat went up and it sucked you up like droplets.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you came back today, that same thing that I felt when you left, it said,
really?
And it came all over me, and I said, he's back. It's really cool stuff. It's a human being going through what was meant to be that a lot of people will never see.
Yeah.
And because I can't see, I can see it. And I really
because you can't see, you can see. That's beautiful.
I'm grateful.
Yeah.
I'm really grateful. Because for whatever little bit of time life has that I have you around, it's like...
Yeah.
It's really cool. It's rain. So I'm gonna go and come back and see Rain Man another day.